The Lady Star Run Charity Walk is an event that brought joy to the hearts of many children in inner cities and poor neighborhoods. Held a few months after Halloween on January 17th, it was a costume hero event that kicked off the new year in the spirit of peace, understanding, and unity. As a kid, you may have heard that the event had political or even racial undertones, but its roots actually go back to a pre-civil rights, pre-World War II era. At the end of the war, America went superhero crazy. Parties were held in Las Vegas, Chicago, and back in New York. Dr. Laurie Stern and his assistant Professor Lance Clark used a secret serum to transform an average brawler vigilante group called the Hall of Heroes into a men's only group of super-powered heroes. But a second war was just around the corner. A new breed of heroes dubbed the New Sentinels enlisted in the war first and garnered national headlines. Not to be outdone, the Hall of Heroes sped up production of its unstable serum. Because of their indelible courage, most of the New Sentinels were killed in the Second War, leaving mostly the mentally unstable Hall of Heroes to return to New York. There, they found a post-prohibition era of gangland activity that was fighting against the next generation of super-powered gapes. As jealousy and infighting grew within the Hall, so did their dramatic turn from hero to villain to supervillain. But just then, a new breed of heroes landed in New York. Their nemesis archvillain was a trio of beings called the Third Men, whom they had pursued through 15 star systems. As the world changed overnight with scientific evidence that we were not alone, the women's liberation movement gained steam. Fueled by the men's only attitude of the times and rumors of gender atrocities committed by members of the Hall that were covered up, feminist propaganda fueled a new wave of lady heroes heralded by Lady Starwind. But when an evil galactic countess named Gal Gal landed in upstate New York, a group of female capes confronted her and were slaughtered, left in the fields of upstate New York. Meanwhile, in Harlem, a capes vigilante named Saint Cease or Six was dealing a heavy blow to prohibition gangsters. But in the South, two Southern poverty law students converted a library into a fortress of friendships and started the first integrated young adult heroes group called the Coalition of the Brave. A civil rights leader named Brother Williams was reported to be using telepathy in his approach to changing the Jim Crow South. Reaching out to Lady Starwind in New York, he invited her down for a peace march through the streets of segregated Memphis to remind America that racially integrated power beings were not the threat, racial segregation was. Lady Starwind left New York and headed for the South. Once she arrived, she was greeted by the full roster of the Coalition of the Brave. After marching through violent, poor, and segregated neighborhoods in Memphis, she joined as an honorary member of the Coalition and took on Jim Crow South corruption and crooked black politicians. Even today it is not uncommon for city officials to be added as popular vigilantes outside their government offices. Though rumor has it that the original Lady Starwind was killed in action in the jungles of Guam in 1973, Kit Mercer and her daughter Aria Mercer have kept this national tradition alive every January.